Hello, everybody. Welcome to the 2019 preseason test at Daytona International Speedway, where there has been a flurry of activity both in the garage area and on the track as the teams try to sort out these new cars, including the new Ford Mustang, getting a grips to what's to come. We've got new points, the new cars, as I said, new tracks, a lot of driver transfers, a lot to talk about. So let's just dive right down into it with the starting person, the person who's topped the time sheets here at Speedweeks in secret car runs. That is the 41 car of Daniel Suarez, who was previously the 19 car of Joe Gibbs Racing, but has moved now to the Stuart Haas organization, driving a Ford now. Clearly, Haas will be one of the teams to beat the Ford Mustang, proving it is one of the slipperiest cars out there. Expect him to be fighting for pole position come qualifying for the Daytona 500. Will definitely be a contender for the race, although that being said, the draft, you never know here at Daytona. It's always a gamble. Moving on now to the 8 car of Daniel Hemric. This will definitely be a development year for his team and the entire Richard Childress Racing organization. He did one race in the Premier Series last year at the Charlotte Roval. He did quite well, actually. Childress itself, though, is lacking engine performance, apparently. They're going to have to rely heavily on Austin Dillon to step up for the 2019 season and get some points and some funding for Childress Racing. Moving on now to the 00 car of Landon Castle, another Childress Racing satellite affiliate. He's new to the 00 machine in search of a better ride, trying to punch his way up the finishing positions. He's hoping for a good finish here in points in 2019 to attract Richard Childress and hopefully get a ride at the main Childress organization for 2020. But a lot of time to come, a lot of racing has to happen before he can do that. Once again, make-or-break year for Ty Dillon. Barely hung on to his ride after 2018, and now in 2019, the team has said they're willing to ignore the demands from grandfather and owner Richard Childress and actually fire him midway through the season if he doesn't start producing. The team said they want regular top 15 results, otherwise they're going to be in search of a new driver at the halfway point of the 2019 season. One person who is in no danger of losing their ride is the previous year's champion of Joey Logano, who has been performing quite well, it must be said, here at Speedweeks. Team has said that the 22 and the 2, everybody is very confident here going into Speedweeks. Definitely expect them to be fighting for pole position along with the 41 of Daniel Suarez. It just might be a Ford Mustang dominated first round of the season, but you never know. The draft is always a big mix-up, and their teammate, the 12 car, has been struggling a little considerably off the pace compared to the 2 and the 22, which is a little bit strange, but we will see what comes. Going along with the pessimism and the struggling is the 21 of Paul Menard, similar to the 12, a little bit off the pace, suggesting they might be sharing some data with the 12 car of Ryan Blaney. The team are going to have to sort that out very quickly before the green flag falls in just a few weeks' time. Moving on now to the 15 car of Ross Chastain for Premium Motorsports. They are a team that is very low on funding right now, as you can see, no sponsors for the test. They're looking for a big result at Daytona, a miracle, to put themselves into the spotlight to pay for the rest of the season, because at the moment they only have a few of their races covered so far in 2019. Another driver who's looking for some good results is the 6 car driver of Ryan Newman for Roush Fenway Racing, moving from the 31 to the 6 machine with the Oscar Mayer Wiener sponsorship of the bright orange car. They are bad fast right now, but extremely unstable in the draft. It is going to be an interesting race for them to come for sure. Another car who's going to be an interesting result is the 95 of Matt DiBenedetto, say that 5 times fast, running some satellite Joe Gibbs Racing equipment. He's been practicing his road course ability over the winter break. Expect him to be good in the many road courses that are to come. Moving on now to Corey LaJoie for Go Fast Racing, who's actually been performing above expectations here in Speedweeks. He's hoping to be on the coattails of people such as the Childress organization using their ex-Roush parts, which is very optimistic. The team is bonding well. They have an ex-Joe Gibbs engineer who came out of retirement to help them for 2019. It's very exciting. On to Matt Tiff now, who joined Front Row Motorsports this season. He's excited to be up in the Premier Series, but at the moment he said he's just going to keep his head low, try to rack up some miles, and gain experience for this season. Low expectations so far. A little bit higher expectations for Chris Buescher, though. He's been in the sport several years now. This is definitely a make-or-break season for him at JTG Doherty Racing. He's hoping to attract some Hendrick opportunities for 2020, but we need to see. Daytona will tell. If you want to talk about make-or-break pressure, you have to talk about the 43 of Darrell Wallace Jr. They only have enough funding, enough sponsorship for the first 4 to 5 races of this season. He hasn't been so good in preseason testing so far, but they need to find speed quickly if they want some sponsorship for the rest of the season. Speaking of sponsorship, the 40 of Jimmy Johnson picked up a new sponsor, that is Ally, over the winter break, and they're using that funding to good use towards the top of the timesheets here in Speed Weeks. Not quite as strong as the likes of Suarez or Stuart Haas, but they are feeling confident going into this first Super Speedway race. Now, another big talking point, Martin Truex Jr. moving to the 19 car with a Bass Pro sponsorship for 2019, bringing Colburn with him and all of their know-how. Expect them to be a main contender for the championship for 2019. They were oh so close in 2018. Can they pull it off here this season? Exciting times at the 51 camp for Cole Custer, Rick Ware Racing, where they surprisingly found a lot of pace here in Speed Weeks, suggesting the Pro Motor Racing found something that the big teams didn't. They could be a contender for qualifying, but they will definitely be trailing off in the normal races with their low funding. A team that is not short on funding right now is the one car of Kurt Busch at Chip Ganassi Racing, who's very excited about transferring to a new team, getting himself a fresh start. They don't have the ultimate pace right now of teams like Penske and Hendrick, but expect them to get faster as the season goes with further development with an additional car in the stable. What car am I talking about? I'm talking about the new entry, single car 78 at AJ Foyt Racing, who purchased the ex Furniture Row Racing assets such as tooling, etc. The employees of Furniture Row Racing actually moved to AJ Foyt Racing. They are running a Chevrolet from the IndyCar connection, so they're going to be using chassis from Chip Ganassi Racing and a drivetrain from Hendrick Motorsports. Now, it has to be said, right now their budget is stretched thin from acquiring all of those FRR assets. Without money for a two-car team of full-time experienced drivers, expect them to run this single car with two part-time young gun drivers of John Vining and Timothy Tennery. Expect Timothy to be handling most of the ovals, as he is an oval specialist coming from the short tracks, the likes of the Snowball Derby, etc., and was actually scouted by Kyle Busch before anybody. And on the other hand, expect John Vining to be focusing on the road courses. He's done several SCCA championships, SVRA entries, a lot of semi-professional racing before this. This is his first time ride, and is very excited for the likes of like Lime Rock and Sebring, these really dark horse tracks that nobody else has been to, but he has a deep understanding of and is very excited about the possibilities of 2019. The entire team is, as a matter of fact. Who knows what will happen with this team? All we can do is wait to find out. Let's take some time now to talk about the point system for 2019, which is drastically different. First place will receive 50 points, second place will receive 40 points, third will get 35, fourth 32, then 30, and going down 2 points until 19th gets 2 points, and 20th gets the last point available. Beyond that, nobody receives any points, which is very, very crucial. It means there's a lot of reward for not starting parking and fighting for the top 20 positions. And now, let's talk about the schedule for 2019, which features 20 races, okay? 20 races, several are road courses, Sebring, Sonoma, Mossport in Canada, and then we are actually moving the All-Star race, amazingly, to Detroit, home of the manufacturers such as Chevrolet and Ford. And then right after that, we have Michigan, which is the halfway point. Then the teams are going to be traveling to Europe, to Belgium, in fact, for the one-off European round of the championship at Spa. This is going to be one of the main wild cards, along with the Charlotte Roval Watkins Glen at race 15, and then Lime Rock, another race nobody has been to. Several wild cards. Nobody knows what's going to happen with this season. And then obviously, everybody is well aware now the teams that the finale will happen at Darlington. What? Nobody is going to be able to predict what will happen at that race, especially with the fact that the points is now, you get the points you get. If you have the most points at the end of the season, you win the championship. No playoffs, no points for leading a lap, no extra points for a win, etc. Whoever gets the best finishes wins, period. This is a knockdown, drag-out fight, and everybody is very excited. And there is one more twist in the turn of this 2019 season that we're going to talk about. So this is what all the fuss is about. Instead of the field being frozen as soon as the caution flag waves, the field will now be frozen at the conclusion of the lap. This has been a highly controversial topic amongst the drivers, but NASCAR has decided that due to modern vehicle safety and response times of the safety crews, the drivers will now be allowed to complete the lap for a fair and legitimate determination of position of the field. Along with this change, the restarts will now be single file to prevent unfair bias towards the top or bottom grooves on restarts. Along with this change, we will now have specified race distances. No overtime or those extra green-white checker things where teams have to worry about if they can make another 50 miles into the race, because once we complete a 100-lap race, or however many laps it'll be, the race will be over. It'll make it much clearer for the fans. And that just about wraps up the first preseason test of 2019 here at Daytona. In 1 week, we will release footage of the Belle Isle tire test at Detroit. That will be all-star event, actually. It should be quite exciting. We'll get a better determination of who to look out for here in 2019. Do drop a like. Make it interesting. Give us a comment. Let us know what you like, what you're interested in, who you're pulling for in 2019. As always, I'm Apex Hunter. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Now I'm going to see you next time. Bye-bye.